Good morning. Welcome to St. Michael's Church as we gather to celebrate the funeral for Maria de Sousa, our sister in Christ. We ask that you please turn off your cell phones at this time and face the back of the church.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. The day of her baptism, Maria was welcoming to the church in the parish of Senhora das Candeias, given new life in Christ and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet the body of our sister, and we surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister to the mercy of God, and promise her in will be fulfilled.
As we begin the Mass of Resurrection, please join us in the hymn.
Dear friends, I welcome all of you here this morning, and particularly I want to acknowledge Deacon Joe Viveiros, who grew up with a few houses down from Senhora Maria. Seja bem-vindo, Deacon Joe, and Joe in Canada, and Deacon John, welcome to have you here. My dear friends, we pause for a moment to acknowledge God's need for mercy and forgiveness as we end the mystery of the Eucharist. Raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. You give pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Maria, whom you have called to journey to you, and since she hoped and believed in you, Grant that she may be led to our true land, to delight in its everlasting joys, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, with the Holy Spirit, unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. But the souls of the righteous of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their death will be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction, but they are at peace. For in the sight of others, they were punished, their hope is full of having been disciplined a little, they will receive good, because God tested them and made them worthy of himself, like gold in the furnace, tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of temptation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. And rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth. The faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Through the darkest, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Though I walk through the darkest valley, shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. Though I walk through the darkest valley, for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. You prepare before me in the presence of my enemies. Overflows. Oh, I walk through the darkest valley. I fear no evil, for you are with me. Goodness and mercy shall follow the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Though I walk through the darkest valley,
a reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. With him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead, glory of the Father, so might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that we are from sin, but if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord be in your heart and your lips, and joyfully proclaim the good news.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Your words, O Lord, are spirit.
The Lord
and with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time Jesus said, I thank you, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chose to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On behalf of this faith community, the family of parishes, but particularly St. Michael's, to whom Maria was very faithful, we want to extend our deepest sympathies to Billy, to your families, and to the extended families who are here. Je n'ai senti part de vos cris de mort à vos amis. η παροχιάνα. Dear friends, no one escapes some sort of suffering and inevitably death. If we had a choice, we would skip suffering and delay death as long as it was possible. Although the beautiful life, but I know that we are looking for some more, of course. However, at the end of the day, that is not our decision. Even though we live through the most modern, sophisticated society, both in health as well as in technology. As we come to bury our loved ones, we come face to face with the fragility of life and realize we have been loved, and now we have loved those that have lives. And we are starkly reminded that life is a gift and life is never to be taken for granted. Although, in human weakness, we do that. As people of faith, as Maria was, we also know that death is not the end. We hope and trust that we will be reunited with our loved one, our loved ones, as Jesus promised that for those who follow him and are faithful to him, life does not end. It is transformed and changed. The Lord has assured us not to be afraid, as we heard in the first reading. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, mine. This may be difficult for us to understand, but before we were born, God already called us by name. That's how close God is to each one of us and knows us intimately. And his whole desire is always that we return to him, because we have come from him through human means. Maria's immigrants had to trust the Lord as they crossed the big ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, or to come to a different country, where to a different culture, language, customs, food, even. And to adjust to all of that. Willing to take this chance, our immigrants of all kinds, because they wanted to create a better world, but mostly for you as a family, to ensure that you had a secure future and that lots of doors and possibilities opened up for you. As at that time, in the Azores, that was not as possible as it is, of course, today. They're very different. These lovely immigrants and this age group were conscious of their duties. No question about knowing. Today we wonder a lot, you know, should I be married, not married? Am I still in love, not in love? You know, we kind of go with the fad of the day. But this generation didn't ask that. I'm married. That's it. I'm a mother. I'm going to be a mother. And we know all of that as challenges and difficulties, of course. But it wasn't about debating, you know, do I feel good today or not so good? And do I feel like doing this or not? There was a real sense of just duty and commitment. And they were responsible, both as citizens. There were also people that you could trust. They had word of honor. We had very little ago. We trusted each other. We just had words of honor. It is a wonderful thing. I'm not for the past, although I can certainly appreciate the past, but it's good to know where we have come from. End of life, what we most remember is the love that we received, and in this case, who is just central to our lives, to the shaping of the way we will grow up and the way we will live, the way we will, you know. And we remember the sacrifices that were made, both by her and Fernando, her husband, made a home and a stable home for their children and to indeed to ensure that they reach their potential, safe, and not just the economic stability, but also emotional and spiritual stability. Maria in Ann's home was beautiful. She loved gardening. She had a huge love. Did she grow a lot of vegetables? Or was it your father's job? I'm asking you. Both? Great. Excellent. And of course, she loved vegetables and they're delicious and was very proud of it. She was a very talented woman who could create beautiful things through her crochet and knitting. And as well, I guess, she was the barbecuer. It always implies that we like food. That, of course, all human beings like that. But we also like gathering together around the table. And I always make that we are so good at gathering around our tables with food. But this is what we do every Sunday. Every Sunday. This is a table. This is a table. And just as we gather to celebrate, rightly so, those wonderful events in our lives, a regular routine, I wish that we could make a connection with the kitchen table and the altar table at Mass. Table of word, table of bread and wine, my friends. She also considered her church her home as she came to Mass faithfully and regularly, and even to weekday Masses, and of course, very faithful, a woman of prayer. She and her husband had been, and they took a lot of pride and certainly participated and were engaged in the religious festival, nas procissões, nas festas religiosas, as atividades sociais. We thank God for her life and for her love and commitment to you. But not only you, to her, but also to her family and friends. We send her to God from and pray that she may be embraced by the good shepherd we just celebrated on Sunday, who will welcome her in paradise, where there will be no more nursing homes, no more suffering, no more pain, and she will no longer have to live with that paralyzing disease of dementia. And we know how crippling and imprisoning that is. And we know that she can now be freed from this. For those of us left behind, we are reminded that life is fragile. Again, life is a gift, never taken for granted. And that we too hope to be with our loved ones someday. Live good and holy lives here on earth so we can be in heaven. Legacy of someone who was loving, faithful as a wife, mother, a sister, and a faith-filled woman. We all want to remember our loved ones, and we want to honor them in the years to come. But I always recommend, I suggest that the best way to remember them is to imitate their principles, their morals, their values, the goodness that they leave. That's a legacy that will live forever. Todos nós que permanecemos na Terra, nós todos temos de lembrar os nossos queridos defuntos, é claro, temos de lembrá-los e recordá-los, e mesmo uma das melhores maneiras, além de visitar os cemitérios, as flores, sem dúvida de visitar, que eu adoro, que eu acho muito bem que nós fazemos essa, lembrá-los de várias maneiras. Eu acho que uma maneira muito marcante de lembrar deles, de recordar e manter a memória viva, é as qualidades, as virtudes e a sua vida moral, os seus compromissos e os maiores legados. And so, my friends, we say goodbye. Maybe not goodbye, how about I really believe that. I'm not just trying to make it, you know, make the pain of death just life. We do. That's why we pray communion of saints when we go to church, so that we can be with them someday. And so, for us who are left behind, particularly the family, we pray that God and Jesus the Good Shepherd will comfort you, bring you peace and strength in the days ahead. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He shows us the way back to the Father. And so with confidence, we present the following needs.
For Maria, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our sister Maria, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Maria, that they may be consoled in their grief, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And for all of us assembled here this morning, here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. For these intentions and all the others that are in your heart this morning, we lift them up to you, Lord, knowing that you have heard our petitions. Comfort and strengthen the family who grieve the loss of their loved one. And Lord, may we be resolved to continue to walk closely to you so that we too may be called into your loving arms and embrace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Daughters will bring up the gifts. As our gifts are brought forward and the altar prepared, please join us in singing our offertory hymn.
The channel of your peace, there is, let me bring your love, Lord. There's thou true faith in you. The channel of your peace. Wash me, O Lord, from all my iniquity, and cleanse me from all my sins. Pray. Father, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept my sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Maria may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great we are all united through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory and called back into life. And so with the powers of God, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Oh, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was over, the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the new and everlasting and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Name your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Ronald Peter, our Bishop, the order of bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your daughter, Maria, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with you, with your Son, in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. And to all of our departed brothers and sisters, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ the Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As beloved daughters and sons of God, we pray in the words that Jesus taught us, como filhos e filhas de Deus amados por nosso Pai, oramos a oração que Jesus nos ensinou, and you may pray the Our Father in whatever language you wish. Pai nosso, que estais nos céus, santificado seja o vosso nome. Venha a nós o vosso reino. Seja feita a vossa vontade, assim na terra como no céu. O pão nosso de cada dia nos dai hoje. Perdoai as nossas ofensas, assim como nós perdoamos a quem nos tem ofendido. E não nos deixeis cair em tentação, mas livrai-nos do mal. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, for the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to each other the peace of Christ.
Peace with you, brother.
Thank you.
Peace with you. May this mingling of the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy, be for me protection in mind and body and the healing remedy. World, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive him.
The body of Christ. Everyone is invited to come forward during communion. If you are not Catholic or are Catholic but not practicing your faith, you will receive a blessing from the Eucharistic minister.
The body of Christ.
You can indicate this by placing your arms like this.
The body of Christ. Right there. In between the chairs. Why don't you do the choir? Okay. Publish the other key. Are you receiving communion or no? Okay. O corpo de Cristo. O corpo de Cristo. The body of Christ. 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 O corpo de Cristo. O corpo de Cristo. O corpo de Cristo. Podem aqui, go on this side as well, please. O corpo de Cristo. O corpo de Cristo. Cristo, o corpo de Cristo, o corpo de Cristo, the body of Christ, the body of Christ,
amen.
The body of Christ, the blessing of God. Thank you. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. I will give you the sea you shall not drown.
the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. And before the power of hell and death is at your side. Oh, that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go for you. Oh, sorry. Yeah, okay. I will give you
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Maria, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we go up, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, she shared in the death resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Maria, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Does bring you along your way.
Greet your hopes as
turns into day. Undone, and death will be no more. Songs of the angels bring you home before the face of God. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, Maria, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, we'll rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks, God, for the blessings you bestowed upon her during her earthly life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we meet in Christ. And we are with you and our sister Maria forever. My dear friends, I want to thank all of you for being here, of course, to support the family and choir. You guys do such a wonderful job. We always send our beloved dad VIP, okay? VIP lounge, first class. And for all of those who prepare the liturgy, thanks to Deacon John and Deacon José. We've been friends for many, many years. We've journeyed together through thick and thin. Altos e baixos. Muito obrigado pela tua presença. Prazer estar contigo. Okay? You want to say any words? Okay. And the altos. I can affect you guys. This is the A-team. Okay? See? Well, Be thankful that I thank you guys. I acknowledge you. Okay. Please. Dear friends, may every motion and every gesture of friendship that you give to one another be a sign of God's. In peace, we take our sister to her final place of rest.
renewed by God's word and the Holy Eucharist, we continue our journey of life, knowing God is always with us. Please join in singing with the choir the recessional hymn.
Fala à vontade. Bom dia, bom dia. Está qualquer dia. Bom dia, querida. Estou ok, tu? Duas mortes, três mortes. Bom giorno, bom dia, bom dia. Bom dia, bom dia. Passem bem. Bom dia. Bom dia, passem bem. Hello, my friend. How are you?
My friend.
Yeah.
My Ehrman.
Don't you like to be called friend? Don't you like to be called friend?
Yeah, but that's not my name.
Okay, Herman. Mas é Herman ou Ehrman, you?
Ehrman.
Okay, então pronto. Good to see you, my dear. Yeah? No, I have so much to do. I haven't seen Father Tom for two weeks.
But you're about lunch. You're going to do something. Lunch, you want something or just...
No.
No, you're fine.
I'll be fine, yeah.
I don't make... Because
no,
os kids,
no.
Os meus kids
I'm going to go to the Lebanese restaurant. Quer ir comigo?
Não, querido.